evening, everyone. Thank you so much for joining us for our final show of the day. We're looking forward to our Year 5 and Year 6 pupils Christmas show. They've put a lot of time and effort in preparing for today, so I hope you enjoyed the show. The staff have put in a lot of time and effort as well. We're really looking forward to starting to celebrate Christmas with you tonight. We've organised for a professional photographer and videographer to be with us as well tonight, so we will share the footage of the show with you as soon as the pictures and the videos are available. I hope you enjoyed the show, and before we start, can I ask you to give a big round of applause to our students to encourage them tonight. Thank you.
Hello, and welcome to our Christmas performance, The Christmas Stars. Today, our performance is a fun-filled Christmas story, taking us on a wonderful journey through heaven as the stars are about to depart to guide the people on earth. We mustn't forget that the story of Christmas is an annual Christian festival celebrating the birth of Jesus Christ. It is a time in the year that brings families, people and whole communities together to demonstrate kindness, sharing and caring for our loved ones. Please put your hands together for the Christmas Stars. we can welcome Year 5B to the stage to sing We Need a Little Christmas. Thank you. 5 will now sing Feliz Navidad.
nor notifications, how am I supposed to know what to do?
And stars must be shiny.
Brilliant.
Glittering like us.
We're glitter.
The most important stars of the Alpha Centauri quadrant.
You certainly are not.
We are the brightest, most distinguished star in the Alpha Centauri quadrant.
Stop, stop. It's almost time for you stars to take your places. We don't have time for all this bickering.
Yes, dog. I sad.
It's that small!
That horrible, awful small!
David is balloonsing and ruining the sky, and no one can see us performing on our path.
Because we are stars!
but the humans need the clouds to bring them rain and snow. They couldn't live without them.
But all that smog is unnecessary! It just makes us dry!
Well, sweetie, run along and get all the polished stuff. You can't have a climb from the stars. No, can we?
Of course not.
You just can't keep up, I'm afraid of me.
We set the standard, you know.
I'm Sparkle. We do so sparkle.
We are the prima donna, the role model.
We think not!
We are the brightest stars in the galaxy.
Numero uno.
The Alpha Premier.
Sirius, the North Star, the Dog Star.
People all over the world depend on our appearance to get them to the right place.
Why, without us, mankind would be lost.
Lost?
Yes, lost. Before all those inventions humans have today, they relied on the stars to guide them.
No one dared venture across the sea, or an ocean, or anywhere out of sight of their star charts.
If they were going to cross the desert, they needed to be guided by the stars too.
You see, by knowing where we are, they know where they are and how to get where they are going.
That sounds like an important job.
Of course it is.
And we are the key star to all directions.
Me,
Sirius.
Until those people invented maps and compasses and GPS.
Now they don't seem to need the stars as much anymore.
We're back!
Do we look any better?
Give it some hope, Captain Pollock. I hope we do better like we used to.
You look just fine, darling.
You look as good as...
You usually do.
What was that you mumbled?
Was that some wise remark?
All I said is you look as good as you usually do.
What do you mean by that?
Stop! Stop! It's almost time for you stars to take your places.
I cannot go back to my spot. I just can't. The brown cloud of Endeavor tarnishes me.
I want to transfer to Australia's outback, or better yet, Antarctica.
There's no pollution to speak of there, and everyone would see us.
And no people to admire you either. If anyone deserves to transfer, it's us.
For almost a month now, we've had to go through all those Christmas lights. People are so busy looking at them, they forget to look at us.
The audacity!
No, I should be transferred.
Enough! Everyone is staying where they got assigned in the beginning.
But this one had no assigned place.
He made an exception that one time.
Yes, he did, and right around this time of year. That was because his son was being born. That was a one-time thing.
We don't have time for this. We don't have time. We don't have time for all this arguing. We don't have any instructions of where we should put them.
Have you had any smart training?
No. Well, we certainly can have them follow us.
We have enough team right now.
Our brightness, our glittering.
We wouldn't be called glitter without our glittering feet.
I certainly can't be responsible for death.
We must pay attention to our radiance and our sparkle.
That's why we're called Sparkle.
Stick with a twinkle. Twinkle!
Did I hear my name called?
Twinkle! That's me. Did somebody call Twinkle?
Twinkle, twinkle, little star. How I wonder what you are. Up, up, up.
Save for later, Twinkle. We don't have time.
Serious, it's time.
I'm next. Do I look alright? see any tarnish?
Six.
Pollution.
Five.
Four. Three. Two. One.
Shine bright, all night, sparkle.
Glitter, are you ready? Then off we go.
I have to go and find out someone who knows us. What's going on. Can you see yourself out of the back?
We don't go out for a while. Explain the rocks as best as you can.
Gotcha!
We're Twinkle.
Sure you've heard of us.
We can both talk about the sun about wished upon a star and all the galaxies.
Sure you've heard.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so bright, like a diamond in the night. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are.
That's us, Twinkle. Sometimes it chants.
Starlight, starlight, first star I see tonight. I wish I may, I wish I might, have a wish I wish tonight.
Sometimes it's about me because they see me first.
Usually it's serious, you know. The North Star, the Dog Star, it's the number one if you like to call them so.
Can we wish on you? We wish Mr. Sandman would find a name for us and a place.
Sure, go ahead.
No, wait, it won't work.
I'm not the first, right? So fine. Have to be the first.
No, sorry.
Oh, look, here comes the Star of Bethlehem.
We'll pass after that one.
Good evening, Bess.
Beth, that's what I call her. It's short for Bethlehem.
Wow, can you believe the Christmas season is almost over?
Not as exciting as the one she sang some years ago, is it?
That was her name to shine, wasn't it?
Yes, and who might she be?
Don't know.
Doesn't have her name or assignment. Tell me to find out.
She just showed up with no training, no instructions, no name.
Just appeared, like out of nowhere.
Poof!
Here she was, just like that.
Poof!
Dear, oh dear, I still don't know what am I supposed to do with them.
But right now, we have to get you out into the night sky.
Five, four, three, two, one, shine bright all night.
Bye for now.
See you around.
Later.
Beth, you look wonderful as always. The Christmas season is almost over.
Are you sad?
No. We keep Christmas in our hearts all year long.
What about us, sir? What's the become of us?
That's just it. I don't know.
There's nothing in the orders about a new star tonight.
Beth, dear, dear, I have to go find someone who knows what's going on.
Can you see yourself out from the back?
Of course. Now, what shall we do with you?
You seem quite little to be a star.
I wonder, maybe you have some special purpose like I do.
What was your special purpose?
Can we ask you a question?
Of course.
The other stars seem kind of stuck up. Why do they act like that?
I don't think stars realize that they are not there to glorify themselves, but to give direction, not to be the center of attention.
How?
When people look up at the heavens and see us, they can marvel at the one who made us. Sometimes we have some special purposes as well.
What was your special purpose?
2,000 some years ago, we appeared in the sky where no star was ever seen before. You see, Jesus, the Son of God, was to be born in Bethlehem. God wanted the wise men to be able to find him, but they had to travel a very far distance, on a route they had never traveled before.
God chose me to lead them to a stable where Jesus in Bethlehem, where Jesus was to be born.
That sounds very important.
Sirius told us that stars, people are guided by stars when they travel, and they've even had assigned places.
That's true, but we were an exception to the rule. Exceptions for an exceptional birth, an exceptional event.
You see, Jesus is the center of everything. Nothing in this world is as important as Jesus, and it was most important for the wise men to find him.
For that special occasion, we outshone all other stars and moved to lead people to the Christ, the Son of God.
After they had found him, I went back to my assigned place.
I love that special shine of mine. They did matter.
I'll always treasure leading people to Jesus.
I'll do my best to be a good star. I want to be a kind star.
No, you won't. You won't be a star at all. This was a mistake, a big mistake. You aren't going to be a star at all.
Aww.
You're going to be a human, you know, one of those people on Earth. Somebody made a mistake and sent you here. Two people, your parents. Your parents are expecting you. I just need to finish my paperwork and then I'll send you to your departure point.
Aww.
Don't be disappointed or sad.
Why?
People may have maps and compasses to help them find their way around Earth, but they still need some help.
That's a job for human beings, not for us stars.
Then that's what I'll do. I'll do my very best to lead people.
Good. I'm glad I met you. You reminded us of Christmas Eve 2,000-some years ago, when another set of parents, Mary and Joseph, were waiting for Jesus to be born. Now, you must excuse us. It's our time to enter the night sky. We'll be watching you as you're born. We'll be watching every night, watching as you lead people to Jesus.
We'll be watching you too. Whenever we see you in the night sky, we'll remember about leading people.
Okay, she's the last star. Now, let's get you to the right place.
Two people, your parents, are very eager to have you arrive.
But you have to leave from a different department. Come on.
Welcome, 6A, to stage with Last Christmas.
Thank you.
now welcome 6B, who will sing Joy to the World. Yes, 6C will now perform Rockin' Around the Christmas Tree. Thank you. 5 and year 6 will now perform O Holy Night.
Thank you.
welcome on stage our music teacher, Mr. Krishner, with Believe.
Please call our head of primary, Miss Caroline King. Thank you, ma'am.
Well, well done. Mr. Crisp, don't try and disappear now. Please come back to the stage so we can give you not only a round of applause for giving us a beautiful end to the show this evening, but also for spending time teaching the children their songs, working really hard with the whole school, and especially giving Year 5 and 6 the opportunity to share Christmas spirit with their parents this evening. So our first thank you will say to you, Mr. So it's so lovely to see you here in the audience this evening. Thank you so much for coming. A very emotional time, I'm sure, for Year 6 parents as it's their last Christmas show. And I'm sure you'll agree they did you incredibly proud. So well done, not only Year 6, Year 5 children as well. Thank you so much for giving us a great show this evening. The spirit of Christmas has truly arrived at ISS. We've had a fantastic day, and to finish it with our oldest children, who have as well put so much effort into their costumes, learning their lyrics, the actors, the soloists, we really think that you have done us proud this evening, Year 6 and Year 5. Well done. Your songs are tuneful, you knew when to come on the stage, you didn't miss a cue, so I'm sure that your parents are going to be incredibly happy when they take you home this evening, and you look amazing, don't they? They look amazing. So thank you, parents, as well, for supporting and putting so much effort into that. Also, a really big thank you to our PTA, who took the time to decorate ICCS for us today and to make the whole venue look festive and spirited for us here at ISS, and the crew at ICCS also for supporting us throughout the day with our lighting and our sound, and ensuring that all the shows look professional and really help the children feel like they were performing and they could really do their best. So thank you to the team here also. Again, extending a really big thank you to the Year 5 and 6 teachers and teaching assistants who have, of course, put in hours of effort to ensure that the children knew their songs, had their costumes, and were very well organised. So thank you not only to the Year 5 and 6 team, but also the team back at school who have done a lot in the background to make sure that the event this evening ran very smoothly. So thank you to all of the team and teachers in Year 5 and 6 and at Team ISS also. So could be tired of clapping soon. And also, I think our final thank you to Miss Daphne. I'm not going to let you hide this time. Where is Daphne? At the door. Okay, you might try. Miss Daphne, thank you so much. We know that you have really supported Mr. Chris throughout, working through this whole event and tirelessly throughout the days and weeks to build up to this, between here and school, and working with the children to polish up and ensure that they had a great event. So a big, big thank you to Miss Daphne this evening also, please. So children, the stars of the show, we're going to hand back over to you to send us off all in festive and merry spirit. Again, big well done and thank you.
Parents, we would kindly ask you to join us in with the last song, Hark the Herald. The words are in the program. If you can kindly join in with the last song, we will appreciate that. Thank you very much.